Bhagavatam, it says, Komaram, Acharit Pragyo, you should start spiritual life 5 years of age. Komaram, Kumar is what age? 5. This is the instruction that if you want to be successful, you start early. When your children are small, teach them Bhagavad Gita slokas. Teach them, they can memorize them. When they get older, tell them what the slokas mean. And go on through life like that. It's a gradual process that keeps on building. If you wait till the end of life, the old person, I told him this afternoon in a story about one expat in America. He was from Brahmin from Bangalore. And he always told his children, wait till you get old. His children were the series. They were practicing chanting Hare Krishna, husband and wife together. He was always telling them, why are you doing like this? And when he got old, came back from America, had his three-story house, had everything. His brother told him, why don't you go to the holy places? Go to Mathura, go to Vrindavan, go to the... Now you're old. You always tell everyone that when you get old, you should do it. So you're old, now you do. He said, I went to Vrindavan, I went to Tirupati, I went to Sri Rangam, but I can't fix my mind there for 5 minutes. I'm not used to it. My whole life I'm only thinking about making money. So all I'm thinking about is where I put my money. Now I got all these crores that I've made all my life. Do I put it in unit trust? Do I put it in fixed deposit? Why are you worrying about it? What do you need anyway? Whatever it is, 2% or not. But this is my habit. Now all my life I'm thinking about all these investments. But now you're going to get old, you're not going to live long. What do you have to do? Your daughters are all married. Yeah, but I have granddaughters. So like you see, what happens is that person gets so much involved that at the end of life, how they're going to switch gear. It's a cheating of Maya that is that people say that, okay, what happens is that you may be in first gear or second gear and through the grihastha life, that's for some people. And then as your children get older, get married, then you can go third gear. But maybe you're older, you should go in the fourth gear. But if you want to start out at 80 years old in the first gear, you're never going to get up to the fourth gear. You're never going to get on. You may not even have enough, you know, momentum to get into the first gear. Some people at 80, they get an awakening, and I've seen some old people become Krishna conscious, even in Russia. But many people, it's not easy. They're very much attached to their whole situation. They go visiting all the time, the children, one house, the next. That they can't fix their mind like that, just on a spiritual life, for sure. And they should go to the, by that time of life, they should be very wise people that can go and visit their children and give them spiritual guidance. But they're just themselves in the first grade. So you don't want to be 70 or 60 years old and start first grade of spiritual life. You want to go through your primary and secondary, you know, already through your student and through your married life. And then by the time you get to the retired life, you should be in a graduate or postgraduate level. And if you want to go faster, you can also, but I'm saying the normal. Doesn't that sound more reasonable? How are you suddenly at 70, you know, even if you said, like, I'm only 55 and they left my reading glasses and I have to go, you know, whole like, it's not the time to begin a spiritual life. You want to start earlier. It's a time that you can concentrate more. Husband, wife, they've already had their children, maybe they're not required that same kind of intimacy they had before. They can focus more purely on spiritual things, where before they had to do it as a family, raising the children together, but trying to do it for Krishna. There's two kinds, it's called yukta vairagya. Doing something for Krishna is like connecting it to Krishna. That's also a type of renunciation. That's what Lord Chaitanya recommended. But then, still you're doing so many material things, it's quite complicated. And how to bring those connecting to Krishna, connecting. Finally, when you have a less things to connect and you can focus in your, like we hope that all the marriages, the couples stay together till their old age. Then what you're going to do in the old age? Sit and watch television? See who wins the sports and all that? But that's the time you should be able to focus more on spiritual life. But if you don't have any taste for it, if you don't have any habit for it. And why? And my mother told me the same thing. You know, I was surprised because not only the Hindu mothers tell this, my mother is a Christian, but she told me the same thing. Why don't you wait till you get old to do this? Why are you becoming a priest at such a young age? Because I joined when I was 19. So she wanted me to obviously do so many things with my life that this wasn't what one of the things she wanted me to do. Then I asked her to tell me how long I would live. And then she said, well, no mother or father can say it. And so how can you tell me to wait till I get old? That's the other thing. Nowadays, some people are dying, car accidents, AIDS, plane, this, that, cancer. Even we're facing now, some of our gurus recently, one last year, died of cancer. He had hepatitis of the liver or something. He had it from before he was a devotee. So these things, you know, there's so many people are dying at different ages. So that's the other thing. If you want to say, okay, the ideal situation should be you practice throughout your grihastha life, and then at end of life you can step up. There's no guarantee even you'll live that long. So then you have zero in your bank account.
Time is on your side, you use it.
Yeah, like what they say, materialists say, when the sun shines, make hay. And spiritually, it's to say, if you have an environment that you're able, like being here in the Gulf was a very good situation to simultaneously do you're getting your economic development, you have your jobs, you have your employment, but you have enough time afterward. There's not so much of a social, when you're at home, there's a lot more pressure. Our people find it easier to practice here. When they go home is the problem. That's the big test. Are they able to keep up with the chanting? Are they able to keep, what do you think? Is that first couple of visits, when everybody, why do you want to do all this religion? Wait till you get all those same arguments everybody uses on them. They have to be able to sustain themselves through all that. Because people have their own way of doing things. Once you know, then you have to be strong enough to know this is what I want to do. This is why we want to do it. And then give these same arguments to them, that how do you know how long you're going to live? You know, you're already old, so that now you should be thinking. I don't know how long I live, so I want to do now. I want to prepare myself. We are not missing out on anything. We have our family, we have our job, we have our children, we have everything, but we've only added Krishna. Yoga Kshemam Baham Yam. Krishna also says, I'll protect what you have and I'll give what you lack. What someone should do in the household life, they should experience whatever there is in material happiness to experience so that they don't look back and say, I missed something. This is the opportunity that But one should do that not in a sinful way, you should do that in a religious way. But that's the what's called a license to enjoy. That they get to experience what is the material happiness. And there's examples of that, like the great Kardama Muni. He also wanted to experience, he had a very romantic life and everything. After doing a lot of meditation, a lot of tapasya, he wanted to experience what is a household life, what is the romance, what is that aspect of life. But he made a prenuptial agreement with his wife. He's a unique case. We're not recommending anybody do this. After giving her a son, he would take sannyas. we're not recommending that. He's a unique case. He's Kardama Muni. He was, not also even on this planet. He's on some extraterrestrial planet. And his son was Krishna, Kapila Muni. So, I don't know, he left the house after that, took sannyas, but the mother had Krishna as her son, so she didn't lose out on anything. But there's some yogi, like some amazing examples, and it's all mentioned in the Srimad Bhagavatam.